7 feet tall, 500 pounds.
He has a giant red beard. He's the one that's kind of always moving around and like doing rock kicks and stuff.
Things that he, because he used to be a metalhead.
He was a big metalhead.
He plays the piano.
He's made 17 answering machine albums.
Day.
He can't stop making music.
He doesn't think and plan though. He just does it.
He just does it. I love B too much sometimes.
I think of it as his tapestry album because it seems to encapsulate so much of his musical history and just rough and rockish.
It's very Brendan.
It's very Brendan. I think he just wanted to make music without being kind of told like, oh, I don't want to do that, or actually kind
that's
of want to do
this.
That's
what I wanted to do.
He wanted to do that.
Yeah, you do your own thing. This actually makes the most sense it's ever made. It was right now, this whole series presents thing we decided to do, going out as Broken Social Scene. It's just more songs, that's all it is. More songs to choose from when we go and play live.
I remember he decided, though, that was it, he was going to do it, and it was literally January 3rd. He went straight into the studio, and he went there every single day that he could. Cause we want love, want to sit through the creation time at night.
Again.
With your thoughts, you know,
I can't see the words.
Just some little rare facts, we decide. They come in like shells that sit right through all the world. And arrive
pieces. Give me one more on that. One more.
Okay, I'll just try it again.
For a while. Cause all that's right is always that's what's wrong.
Like, is there something else you want?
Something like that.
Brendan.
Yeah?
Something like that.
It's 13 months. Like, writing, demoing, recording, mixing, mastering, re-recording, writing. Demoing, you know, some of the songs took quite a long time to come together. Seeing what fits, seeing what makes a good story.
The scattered, like, writing style of this album, I mean, there's definitely no style, no rhyme or reason. It was just jamming, kind of, we've ripped apart every song, put it back together, cut songs in half, trashed songs twice, like, done like hundreds of vocal takes. A lot of the songs were, the vocals were written in the booth, kind of just like jamming out. Brendan's got his pad of paper in there, kind of writing lyrics.
Well, for a record like the one I made, I would recommend to everyone to make a record like that because it takes longer than it could have. We're a bit messy and disorganized sometimes, but get a few decent instruments together, your favorite keyboards, pianos, guitars, basses, drums, good players, you know, that's a good thing to know. Whoever's recording your record, I mean, make sure you get along well with them. You know, relationships are kind of the most important thing, like whoever you're making the music with, or, you know, whatever your atmosphere is in, make sure it's, you know, as comfortable as you can make it. I mean, a good thing to do would have songs written, which I decided that I didn't really have any songs written before recording. We just kind of went, you know, wrote, you know, sort of in a bulk. You know, pre-production is sometimes handy, which we didn't really do either. As far as like, you know, having your band rehearse songs, but because we did our record in such a way that it wasn't really a band per se to start out. Try and figure out what your song's about, which, you know, sometimes it takes me a long time to figure out what songs are about. You know, you have some melodic ideas and a couple of lyrics that sort of just pop out, but then, you know, trying to like have some sort of cohesive line of thought, I guess, is, you know, an important thing for a song. I don't really like to throw in the words broken heart because it's like fucking everyone sings about that, so try to avoid that. try and make sure the when you're finished, make sure the artwork fits your record. I hope ours does. I think it does. You know, have some strategy about how you're going to release your record. I think if you made a good record, you know, people will hear it. Even if it's not that good, some people will hear it.
I think it was just the need for Brendan to keep on creating. And because a lot of the band members were doing their own thing, he, you know, ended up doing his as well, just out of that need that he has to just constantly be writing music. I don't know if you spend enough time with Brendan, he's either got a guitar in his hand or, you know, he's obviously always thinking a new song, a new piano riff, a new guitar hook, something. He can. So I mean, I think it was out of a necessity to just be creative.
When you're, you know, growing up, you know, you sort of identify with certain things and seem like the thing I did best. And you go to play shows and meet people and they're affected however which way by your music. You feel like you're doing something useful. There's just so much music that is problematic for me, you know, all around, that sort of like I feel it's my duty, my selfish duty to exact my feelings about melody and harmony and you know, song construction, to sort of combat the things that just don't sound real. You know, you gotta have your own voice.